Imagine this situation. You are on the sales side and you have been negotiating with someone for a fairly long time, for a few months. Now, you still have a few concessions that you could make. They are painful, but you know you're prepared to make them if this is going to enable you to close the deal. So you decide to make those concessions and make your best proposal. And the person on the other side tells you, well, thank you very much for this offer. Let me review it with my boss. Guess what? The negotiation is probably not over. They are gonna come back with additional requests and you have nothing else to give. This is a typical example of not defining the negotiation process. My name is Giuseppe Conti. I am a business school professor and the founder of Conti Advanced Business Learning, a company that specializes in negotiation and influencing. The advice of today is negotiate the process before you negotiate the substance. What do we mean with negotiating the process? How many meetings are we gonna have and over which time frame? What is the objective of the next meeting? What is the agenda of the next meeting? Where it will take place? Who will be participating to the meeting? Will the person attending the meeting will have authority to make a deal, or they will have to refer to somebody else? When you think about defining the process, also keep in mind a couple of things. If you want to claim value, so if you want to get the best for yourself, then you can shape the process to your advantage. If instead you want to create value, build a better long-term relationship, then go for transparency and clear ground rules. Because we know that negotiators are more satisfied with the outcome of a negotiation if this outcome has been reached through a fair process. For more insight on negotiation and influencing, check our website www.cabl.ch. Thank you very much.